टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर ऑन हिज द पब्लिश्ड पेपर ऑन द फ्यूचर रिसर्च डायरेक्शन इन द कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर फ्यूचर रिसर्च डायरेक्शन इन द customer loyalty and extract of this paper This paper aims to provide future research direction in the area of the relationship between the customer satisfaction emotions and the customer loyalty. Customer satisfaction emotion is important for the survival of the business. Customer loyalty is the important for the survival of the business. Hence, we discuss here the two issue of the customer satisfaction emotion and customer loyalty. The two important word for the survival of the any word are the important. Many of the research institutes are doing that the how the customer will be satisfied. In this case, two major issues are identified in order to provide the future research direction in this area. The first issue being identified is the incomplete customer satisfaction measurement adopted by the many of the satisfaction researchers. The second issue being identified is the lack of study on the relationship between the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. And this issue is the main purpose for the study of the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. The three main recommendations for future studies are made based on the issue identified. The first recommendation is that the future customer satisfaction study need to include a separate emotional scale as part of the overall customer satisfaction measurement. The second recommendation is that the satisfaction emotional scale component needs to be further developed and refined for the different industry and the culture. The third recommendation suggests that the future research need to further explore the relationship between the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. And the third recommendation, explore the relationship between the customer satisfaction and the customer loyalty. The two words, customer loyalty, is the important for the survival of the business. Customer satisfaction emotion is important for the survival of the business. In this paper, researchers have adopted very different view on customer satisfaction definition and the measurement. Some suggested that the satisfaction is the multidimensional, while the other suggested that the satisfactional is the one dimensional. For instance, Sellens argued that the multi-atom satisfaction scales don't make sense because satisfaction is the one dimensional and can be directly accessible from the informant. Winstead also argued that the satisfaction construct is the unidimensional. On the other hand, it was argued that the satisfaction is the multidimensional and the satisfaction measurement need to be consistent with this multidimensional characteristic. What are the multidimensional characteristics of the customer satisfaction, we will take up in the end. In spite of the debate between the one or multidimensional customer character, few recent satisfaction research have raised the importance of the properly measuring the emotional component of the satisfaction. However, while many satisfaction researchers would accept that the emotion is one of the core components of satisfaction, it is still not commonly accepted that a separate emotional scale should be included as part of the overall satisfaction measurement to ensure that this core component is the properly measured. This paper therefore aims to review the existing literature related to the issue, including a separate emotional scale in the overall satisfaction measurement. And emotional scale, separate emotional scale is provided here for the overall satisfaction measurement and implication of using the satisfaction to the predict customer loyalty. It also aims to identify the future research direction based on the literature review. Based on the literature review, there are the two issues being identified in the area of the satisfaction research. The first issue is the incomplete customer satisfaction measurement. The second issue is the lack of study on the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. This paper will firstly review the existing literature related to the incomplete customer satisfaction measurement. Future research implications related to this issue will then be identified with brief discussion. Secondly, this paper will discuss the existing literature related to the lack of custody on the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. Future research implications relates to this area will be identified and briefly discussed. Incomplete customer satisfaction measurement. How the customer satisfaction, incomplete satisfaction measurement is to be given here. To determine whether the existing customer satisfaction measurement is incomplete, it is necessary to examine the common satisfaction definition and measurement implied by the studies in this area. This would enable the researcher to understand if both customer satisfaction definition and scale implied to the measure customer satisfaction are consistent. Therefore, the definition of the customer satisfaction adopted by the recent study will be firstly discussed in the following section. Definition, customer satisfaction and the customer satisfaction emotion. Customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction. Traditionally, satisfaction defines have included both evolution and the emotion element. Anderson concluded that the satisfaction is an evolution of the emotion and that satisfaction should not be understood as an emotion, but an evolution of the various emotions. On the other hand, while it is accepted that the satisfaction is closely related to or includes emotion, it is not clear whether satisfaction is an emotion itself or consists of the several emotions that form the overall satisfaction emotional component. The confusion does not only exist within the construct customer satisfaction. It also exists as the compared to the other construct such as a loyalty. For instance, Bennett and Rudolf Thiele suggested that the strong positive correlation between the customer satisfaction and loyalty could be due to the fact that satisfaction and the loyalty may not be different concepts. Steppes and the Nehas also consider loyalty as part of their satisfaction definition. If customer satisfaction consists of the emotional, cognitive, and the behavior component, there is a significant overlap between the construct of the satisfaction and attitude, as attitude also consists of the emotional, cognitive, and the behavior component. Nevertheless, the majority of the satisfaction study see satisfaction and the loyalty as the different construct. Despite the above confusion within the satisfaction construct itself, and between satisfaction and other construct, there are some characteristics that have been commonly accepted to form the theoretical understanding of the satisfaction construct. For instance, recent study have argued that the satisfaction tend to be seen as a short-term temporal focus rather than the long-term compared to the other related constructs such as a perceived service quality. Ockerton et al. Suggested that the satisfaction is a short-term consequence of the service quality, while trust is a long-term consequence of the service quality. Roest and Peter argued that the construct of the satisfaction is a reflection of the consumer rather than the service, and they suggested that further research restrict satisfaction to the post-purchase process. In order to compare the results from the different study, it is important to imply a consistent definition. And since there are problems in the reaching a universal satisfaction definition among the satisfaction researcher, it is difficult to obtain a universal satisfaction definition to compare the results and with the other satisfaction study findings. After incorporating the key elements from the discussion above, satisfaction in this paper will be defined as an aggregation of the previous transaction specific satisfaction and involves both cognitive and the affective component. And the affective component is an overall evaluation of the different emotions. It is important to note that the many current satisfaction study is still solely focused on the cognitive component of the customer satisfaction and the neglected emotion component. Many customer satisfaction studies have solely focused on measuring the cognitive component of the customer satisfaction, while some researchers argued that the customer satisfaction measurement should also include a separate affective component in addition to the cognitive component. For instance, Stosu and the Nihasu and the suggested that a separate affective component should be included as part of the satisfaction measurement, and the result have developed a satisfaction emotional measurement. Yu and Dan also found that the satisfaction affective component served as a better predictor as a compared to the satisfaction cognitive component. However, this view did not appear to be adopted by the many satisfaction researchers, as many still have not been included a separate emotional scale in their customer satisfaction measurement. The following section will discuss the possible dimension of satisfaction emotional scale component. Customer satisfaction emotion. What are the dimensions are there? Customer satisfaction emotion. Since it is appropriate to include a separate emotional scale component as part of the overall customer satisfaction measurement, it is important then that an appropriate measurement for the satisfaction emotional component is being developed. The emotion framework identified by the Mech and Ilgu consider humor emotion in the general have found that the emotions can be classified as the positive and the negative. Researchers who have focused especially on the consumer satisfaction have obtained a similar conclusion that satisfaction emotion can be classified as negative and positive. For instance, Legender and the Stubrick identified two dimensions of the satisfaction emotion, positive and the negative. The positive emotion included emotions such as happy, hopeful, and the positively surprised. On the other hand, the negative includes emotions included emotions such as angry, depressed, guilty, and the humiliated. While may have suggested that the satisfaction emotion are the two dimensions, the possibility that the satisfaction emotion may be a three-dimensional construct was right in a study conducted by the Yu and Ding using the same emotion framework as the Legender and the Standwick, reported a two-dimensional solution with the anger loading on both the positive and the negative dimension. This finding suggests that there might be another emotional dimension in addition to positive and the negative emotion, especially when the alpha coefficient dropped by the only 0.1 when the anger item was removed. Based on the Mehrabian and Russell study, three dimensions of the emotions, namely pleasure, arousal, and the dominance, have also been identified. In adopting part of this typology in their study, Simpy and Weber demonstrated that the pleasure dimension was significantly related to the some aspects of the loyalty behavior, such as positive word for mouth and future intention for the shopping at the same store. While satisfaction was considered as an emotion within the pleasure dimension, argued that the pleasure can also be called satisfaction because of the consistent utilitarian enforcement nature of these two constructs. Although few recent studies have started to acknowledge the existence of the customer satisfaction emotional component and have attempted to explore the dimension of the customer satisfaction emotion, more follow-up study were needed to further develop an appropriate measurement in order to capture the dynamic of the customer satisfaction emotion. Having identified and discussed the relevant literature related to the issue of the incomplete satisfaction measurement, some future research implications are identified in the following section. Future research implications. Based on the discussion above, some suggestions for the future research in relation to the incomplete customer satisfaction measurement are identified in this section. The first and most important research implication is the future satisfaction researcher need to include a separate emotional measurement to measure the emotional component of the satisfaction. The second research implication is to further explore and refine the satisfactional emotional measurement and the dimension. The third research implication is that studies need to understand if different emotions are being experienced for the different services consumption and in different cultures. Due to the insufficient research in this area, it is not clear that the distinct emotions are experienced while consuming different services. It is also not clear if the consumer from the different culture background would experience different emotions for the same service consumed. After discuss the literature and the research implication related to the first issue identified, the next section will review the literature related to the second issue identified in this paper. Lack of study on the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. Author say there the lack of the study on the customer satisfaction. The second key issue being identified in this paper related to the lack of a study on the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. In order to discuss this issue, it is essential to briefly discuss the nature of the customer loyalty, as it is also a complex construct. The following section will briefly discuss the nature of the customer loyalty. The focus of the following section will be on the differences between the two types of the customer loyalty. Attitudinal loyalty, also called the future behavior intention, and the behavior loyalty. The nature of the customer loyalty. Generally speaking, there are two types of the loyalty, namely attitudinal loyalty and the behavior loyalty. Attitudinal loyalty and the behavior loyalty. Attitudinal loyalty and the behavior loyalty. Attitudinal loyalty tends to focus on attitude towards the loyal, disloyal acts, brand preferences, commitment and attitude toward the brand measure or the probability of the purchase. On the other hand, behavior loyalty tends to focus on the market share. Brand allergic and the exclusive purchase elasticity, and for the price still switching, the behavior approval has been heavily criticized due to the fact that the various factors may influence the behavior, such as repeat purchasing, and by simply measuring the behavior itself. The strategy may miss the attitudinal component of the customer loyalty, such as a preference, namely true. The attitudinal approach has also been criticized for an over-reliance on the consumer's self-report, and the loyalty focus can be blurred in many cases. For instance, it is could be unclear whether the consumer loyalty level measured indicates loyalty towards the brand or the service provider. On the various loyalty behavior intention aspect, word of the mouth is considered to have significant impact of the customer purchasing behavior, and it is often found to be associated with the satisfaction, dissatisfaction. It was also suggested that the future behavior intention is driven by the different factors that depend on the level of the relationship. For instance, for high relational customer, their future intention tend to be driven by the trust and the commitment. Conversely, low relational customer tend to be the driven by the overall satisfaction. After a brief understanding of the customer loyalty has been established in the above discussion, this paper will examine the issue related to the relationship between the customer satisfaction and the customer loyalty in this section. Customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. Of the studies that have focused on the satisfaction-loyalty relationship, only a few have established an empirical relationship between the satisfaction emotion and the loyalty behavior. For instance, has found a significant relationship between the satisfaction score and the switching behavior. However, the emotional element of the satisfaction was neglected in this study. A similar problem has found in the McDonald study, whose findings support the relationship between the satisfaction and the intention to switch and the remain loyal in four services industry: dentist, auto service, restaurant, and the hair styling. Unfortunately, there two-item satisfaction measure did not include a satisfaction emotional component. In examining the emotions-loyalty relationship, Shulley argued that the emotion can be significant predictor for both behavior and attitudinal loyalty perspective. Additionally, it has been demonstrated that the complaining behavior is one of the methods of the venting anger, and dissatisfaction has been linked to the complaining behavior, especially when the likelihood of the redness is relatively high. Matter study also suggested that there is a significant positive relation between the overall satisfaction, dissatisfaction, and complaining behavior. For satisfied user, the complaining is more future suggestion rather than the true complaint. Also, satisfied user tend to engage in positive future loyalty behavior. While these findings are interesting, it is important to note that the mature study was usually a single item yes-no question to capture respondent satisfaction level, and the emotional component of the customer satisfaction has also been neglected. Even for the researcher who have included a separate emotional scale as part of the overall satisfaction measurement, some important impressions were missing in their scales to predict the full customer loyalty. For instance, the emotion included in the Y and Dean's study failed to predict customer complaining behavior intention, who focused on the emotion of the regret and disappointment, argued that the different emotions are likely influence different decisions. Further support for the distinctness of the two emotions, regret and the disappointment, was provided by Iman Dare and the Gia, who argued that the regret and disappointment along with the one of the performance expectation can influence individual's post-choice evaluation, and the symmetric effect of the regret and the disappointment of the post-choice evaluation was found in their empirical study. although Inham and the Jurwal empirical study on the regret further confirm the positive significant relationship between the probability of the repeat purchase and the positive consumption experiences, more study need to be done to test the finding across the industry and the different culture. While it may be logical and easy to argue that the positive emotions are the positively linked to the customer satisfaction and the loyalty behavior. Or the behavior intention and the negative emotion decrease customer satisfaction, the relationship between the emotion, satisfaction, and the loyalty may not be as simple as it appears. For instance, you found that the positive emotion appeared to have a relatively more significant relationship between the positive loyalty behavior. On the other hand, found that the certain types of the negative emotion link positively with the customer satisfaction. Found that the negative emotion seemed to have a stronger impact on the post-choice evaluation as compared to the positive emotion. In addition, the question of the how different satisfaction emotion relate to each other is answered. The area of the different relationship between the customer satisfaction emotional dimension and the different behavior intention is largely unexplored, and future research need to be done in this area. Based on the discussion above, some research implication for the future study are discussed in the following section. Future research implication. The key future research implication is that comprehensive emotional scale need to be developed in order to predict the full customer loyalty. Few satisfaction emotional scales have been developed. However, there is lack of the comprehensive satisfaction emotional scale to predict the customer loyalty dimension. Culture and industry factors also need to be taken into consideration when examining the satisfaction emotional loyalty relationship. Researcher may also consider adopting the concept of the quality satisfaction model proposed by the Strauss and Nehal, which include cognitive, affective, and the behavior intention component. Future research can further develop and refine the different types of the customer satisfaction that are related to the specific cognitive and the affective evaluation. This may be enhance the predictability of the both cognitive and the affective component on the customer loyalty. Conclusion. In conclusion, two main issues related with the customer satisfaction study have been identified. The first issue is the incomplete satisfaction measurement. The second issue is the lack of study on the relationship between the customer satisfaction emotion and the loyalty dimension. To address the first issue identified, it is suggested that a separate emotional measurement to be included as part of the overall satisfaction measurement. It is also suggested that the more fellow of the study needs to be conducted to develop a comprehensive and appropriate satisfaction emotional for the different industry and the culture. To address the second issue identified and the insufficient study have done to explore the relationship between the customer satisfaction emotion and the customer loyalty. Considering the satisfaction emotion appear to have a strong influence on the certain loyalty dimension, more study were needed to further explore the relationship between the different customer satisfaction emotional dimension and the customer loyalty dimension. The relationship between the two constructs may not be as simple as it appears. References are given here. References: Anderson, Anthosopoulos, Bagdieu, Bennett, Ballmer, Doug, Foxall, Gabrino, Jeed, Iman, Lee, and Legender, and Macleod. These are the Macleod, Mangold, and MacDougall, Matter, Odekan, Odin, Roest, Randall, Escapeman, and Stoff and Szymanski, Winstead and you. These are the references given here in the case of the customer satisfaction and the customer loyalty. Hence, today we have discussed about the future research direction in the customer loyalty. Future research direction in the customer loyalty and how to make the customer to be the loyal or to make the customer satisfied. We have discussed here today in the case of the future research direction in the customer loyalty.